In order to keep your lovely tavern clean, I implemented multiple chores for the player to do. There's one issue though. I just got home from work, sat down and realized I don't want to do any more chores. So I built AI staff that you can hire to not only run your tavern, but to keep it clean as well. I'm going to break down the specific logic that I set up and at the end, put them to the test to see if they can run the tavern entirely by themselves for a night. As a lot of you know by this point, Tavern Team is a first-person sim I've been working on where you run your tavern, serve customers, manage resources. But right off the bat, let's get into chores. To start, once a customer is done drinking, their mug obtains a new dirty state with a slightly changed texture to display the lack of cleanliness. This I painted in Blender, and in order to make it easy to distinguish, the outline of the mug glows red when it's dirty. This provides immediate visual feedback to the player. You can still fill dirty mugs and serve them to customers, however, their satisfaction is going to be lower. Cleanliness of the mugs do matter. You can't simply put the dirty mugs back on the shelf. You need to make sure all the mugs are washed at the end of the night before you can close. Now, I needed a way to clean them, so I set up a new interactable. Enter the wash bin. The players can now walk up to it and scrub the mugs here. I added a quick time event. I yoinked a bit of the UI from that arm wrestling stuff I did a little bit earlier, where you need to hit one key when the tick is over the safe zone. If you miss the safe zone, the tick just continues circling until you hit it. I intentionally made this super easy. Washing dishes isn't supposed to be difficult, but chores do require an ounce of effort. So just pop in a podcast while you do it. Now, once the mug is clean, you can place it back on the shelf if I wanted to. A lot of people down in the comments had suggested that I add some sort of mug count to the mug rack where you have a set amount of mugs that you can serve to the customers, but over time you can like buy more. I thought that was really cool, so I'm definitely gonna add that in the future. Hey, it's me from the future. Gas is still expensive, but I wound up adding that mug count. Next, we're gonna look at cleaning up the floor. Now, just pretend for a second that I don't spend my Friday nights coding and instead spend them in a dirty-ass bar or at a friend's frat house. And you know how when you're walking on a dirty, sticky floor and your shoes make that disgusting sound when they're like peeling off the sticky floor? Gross. So, to resolve this disgusting issue, I added this broom mop thing. I don't know. Functions like a mop, looks like a broom. We'll figure it out. I also added a closet where the broom is kept, and after opening the doors, you can grab it and get to work. I did make the spills myself in Blender. There are three separate sizes, with each randomly determining which size spawns when the spill happens. You have to scrub until the spill is all gone, and it'll shrink to a smaller size each time. By the way, if you think the setting and the idea for the game is cool, you might as well sub to see how it's progressing. So next, I need some way that we can make these spills spawn in like an organic manner. So to do this, I added a random chance for this to happen every few seconds when the customers are walking. The rate at which they spawn is dependent on the mug carrier's race. Elves, ever graceful, never spill. Humans, occasional spillage. Dwarves, yeah, you can probably guess. Oh, wait. Dwarven metal is an actual genre? Huh. Now let's get into how we are going to force manufacture willingness from our AI to assist us in completing these chores. The most critical staff to a tavern is going to be the bartender. This guy-gal will wait for customers to show up and order a drink. Once someone is waiting, he will get their order, then proceed to the mug rack, grab a new mug, walk to the ale station, pour a quick pint. Pint? Oh god, I sound British. Anyways, after providing the customers with the recently ordered beverage, they will wait on the next customer and so on and so forth until there are none left in line. Once all the tasks are resolved, he will remain ever vigilant, ready to meet the next customer with a smile, if he had a mouth. Now the next staff type is going to be an actual cleaning person. First thing the staff member will do is to patrol the dining area. If they see any spills, they will break out their broom, which is stored up their sleeve, and quickly mop up the spill until it's all gone. After that, they will resume their patrol. They are also tasked with cleaning up mugs. They will walk over to them, pick them up, and bring them back to the wash station. After scrubbing the mugs, they place them back on the rack, and the cycle is complete. Once that's done, they will loop back into the patrol state and will be able to either clean spills or mugs, whatever is needed. By the way, if you have any ideas for some other staff members I can add, feel free to let me know either in the comments down below or in the community Discord. So now that we have all the main code implemented, let's actually test the AI to see if they can run the tavern an entire night by themselves, hands completely off. All right, let's get started here. So we got a few customers coming in, grabbing mugs, filling them up. Perfect. Perfect. You gonna go to your seat, bud? Yeah, he does. Another one. Very nice. Very nice. All right, bud, you're patrolling around. Do something. Oh. Nice. Nice. Cleaning up the spills. Well done. Oh, you found another. Well, look at this. This is actually working. Huh. Okay, not bad. Also, I want to mention that I made a bunch of quick overhauls to the player. Remember how I've been saying that I'm going to fix this for months at this point? Well, I finally got it working. 7 months later. Definitely didn't spend an entire Saturday on this. I was also able to add animation rigging to the player, and this is how, when he pours the beer, his arms assume the correct positions. Huge improvement over the previous system, which admittedly was pretty mid, so although I could probably polish it more, I love how it looks now. I'm gonna sound so stupid, but I'm actually pretty proud of my AI for not screwing anything up. Man, this is actually really, really smooth. Customers are drinking and leaving. Oh, there we go. And I knew something had to go wrong. Also, if you remember previously, the player's hands used to always be in view. This was because the player object was parented to the camera. I didn't like it, so now I changed up and gave the player the option to vertically rotate, free to a certain degree. And I much prefer this new system. It just adds another layer of immersion, so I feel like it feels like you're actually in the game, which I love. Also, one last player update, I added sounds to the footsteps by using my friend Van's script, link to it down below. Footsteps make specific sounds depending on what they're standing on, so the stone makes a stony sound, and the carpet makes a carpet sound, and the Italians make an Italian sound. Also, I added this neat little pause menu. I really like the UI that I had going on here, but for volume, sound effects, music, I'll add all that in the future, but a good placeholder for now. Oh, he got unstuck. Good for him. You did phenomenal, by the way. Also, I just realized my customers weren't actually dropping the mugs, so I fixed that bug, and let's just display how he picks up the mug and washes it, and then continues on with his normal chores. I have a really interesting idea that I've been prototyping for training the AI. It's a method that I haven't really seen done before, so I'm really excited to show you guys that, but I want to have it completed and working before I brag about it, so that'll probably happen in the next video. If you want to see that or be just kind of like how the game's looking, you can subscribe. That would... Thank you so much.
God, you guys got 1,000.